this video, I will become food reviewer. But this is not your typical food review, because I'm going to places that nobody really goes. And let's call this place Ghost Restaurant. Di Kuching City ada banyak kedai makanan, and kebanyakan kedai memang penuh dengan customer. Kalau kau buat bisnis makanan, aku rasa almost impossible for you to go bankrupt, unless you have weak marketing or your food really. So tujuan video itu ialah untuk investigate kenapa kedai itu siapa banyak customer. So in this video, I could be eating the worst food ever or found hidden gem. This is not pet review video. They don't know me and they don't know I'm recording them. Aku dah scout banyak kedai makan di Kuching, and to be fair to them, aku akan pergi masa mereka peak hours so that we know the real performance of this tempat makan. So aku dah pilih top 5 ghost restaurant in Kuching. So without wasting any more time, let's go. Sekarang me and my cameraman on the way ke tempat yang pertama, namanya Amin Islamic Cafe. Aku dah tengok dalam Google untuk tengok rating kedai tu. So berdasarkan Google, ratingnya cuma 3.6 je. I don't expect much, but since the rating is like that, so yalah. And aku tengok satu review daripada orang yang kata makanan is a bit pricey, so I expect, but I need to spend more on food later on. Sekarang kami dah sampai di Amin Islamic Cafe. Nampak dari luar macam cerita orang. Buka kan tutup? Jom lah tengok. Nampak gayanya kedai ini mungkin pernah famous sebab ada gambar mantan TYT Sarawak dengan mantan Perdana Menteri. Masih ada lagi logo satu Malaysia. Hebat-hebat. Suasana sangat sunyi sepi. Sebelum kami sampai, cuma ada satu family je yang makan. Selebihnya beginilah.
Aku order nasi biryani ayam. Dan my cameraman cuma mau roti canai aja. Visually, I can see the kuah sangat cair. Betul kata orang dalam review. Dirasa belum tahu lagi lah. Harap si tawar. Apa kata orang dalam review juga. So later on, I will rating this food and then the experience. So yes, let's dive in.
How is your canai? Good?
Kari
kuah kacang hijau nasi berapa sedang usah no cair kari itu pun okay, tapi masalahnya nasinya sejuk itu aku rasa
ayam pun very keras dari pagi tadi ikut kau kan gak tau coba aku makan lo testing
iya masam-masamnya
merasa bisa.
Silakan. Okay. Okay. Yeah.
Tepat.
So, teh tarik tadi dalam video review. Saya dapat gue-gue ya. Tarik kasih. I think just normal. Cara buat kuehnya. Ada kamu ada pokoknya crispy kan? Crispy kan sih. Kenapa
ya? Ya macam tadi panas kan?
Ya. Ya ada kasih ada.
Kamu crispy kan lah.
Ya, ya. Kasihannya dah emang ada satu pinggang ya kasih. Saya bilang kok ada tadi aku rasa naik kutip dapat. Ya saya laju.
Yang quality. Siapa ya lah quality standardnya.
So, standar tak turun, because type postnya. Sekarang saya 4.6 rating. Benar lagi kot. Yang penting kita sih food poisoning aja. Okay, so kami dah habis makan. And my experience dengan makanan below average lah for me. Sekarang jam menunjukkan sudah mendekat tengah hari. Kalau ikut Google Map-nya kata this hour peak hour lah, tapi you can see masih banyak orang.
Untuk rating aku akan bagikan kepada 3 bagian, yaitu persekitaran, makanan, dan harga. Dengan rating penuh, 5 markah. Rating kedai Amin Islamic Cafe, persekitaran aku bagi 3/5. Untuk makanan, 1/5. Sorry, you fail the chicken. Dan harga, 2/5. Tak ubah loy harga dengan kualiti makanan. Markah keseluruhan ialah 2/5. So now me and my cameraman on the way to second place for this challenge. I don't know apa the kedai name, but then it's somewhere in Cheng Ho. So let's see.
Cameraman.
Yeah.
Cameraman.
You are my part-time cameraman. Okay, so I am now at the second place, and me and my cameraman today we order ABC. Walaupun hari hujan, very cold, we still order ABC. And this is my just normal ABC, and this one is what family guys. Yeah. Then we also order mee hoon, and then he order roti. So later on we will test lah, doing the test for this bread pan. Is it really good or just they have bad marketing? How is your wet day? Sweet tower. Is that the green one apple?
Yeah.
The same lah, I say wet day for apple. Looks very biasa. It's like...
Kentin,
bukan dikentin. A bit. Maksudnya color, so no. Huh? I'm not color pun, a bit like that. Yeah. Yes, okay lah. I think the question is good. For 6 minutes. So we finish eating. Basically, what I can say, the food is just okay. The ABC, everything pun just okay. Nothing special. And then the bread is burnt, as you can see. If the bun at least like cover with some butter or more kaya lah. I don't know how they burn the bread. But then if you want to go here untuk makan ABC petang-petang atau ice cream, you also can go lah. It's just a very chill place. Now is noon already. I don't know, because of rain, memang nobody knows this place. My rating for this place is just okay. Then. How about you, cameraman? What do you think? From 5 star, how much do you give? 2.5. Bihun
not bad.
Yeah, bihun not bad. Bihun of the day today. Kedai Yummy Snow Ice Rojak. Persekitaran aku bagi 4/5. Sangat kemas dan anti yang friendly. Makanan aku bagi 2/5. Sayang sekali bread yang hangus. Harga 3/5. Portion yang besar aku rasa okay lah. Maka keseluruhan ialah 3/5. Okay, sekarang kami di tempat ketiga, Bombay Spices. Every time I go to this place, memang kosong lah kedai. So let's investigate kenapa this kedai kosong. Jom. Sekarang jam menunjukkan pukul 1 tengah hari and hari Sabtu. Berdasarkan Google Map, this area dalam weekend tengah hari very busy. Tapi hakikatnya suasana yang sangat sunyi. Aku buat video pun cakap slow. Tapi kerusi dan meja mereka nampak fancy. Okay, makanan kami dah sampai. Aku order nasi biryani ayam. I think looks very nice visually. And then naan cheese, very big. I didn't expect this big. But the taste, I don't know lagi lah macam mana. So, let's try.
Very good.
Aduh, ada rambut. Siapa punya bulu mata? Not bad. Very good. Cepat dengan kuah, also very good. Kuah dan cheese. Okay, ayamnya ditanam dalam nasi. Okay, nampak asam. Let's try this chicken. Portion besar lah, I think worth it lah. Okay, kami dah selesai makan. For me, the food is very nice. Bukan macam kedai yang sebelum tu. And then the portion also very nice, very big. Karena air pun besar. This one only cost 4 ringgit. So I think overall is very good lah. I don't know why this kedai selalu kosong. Maybe they just have weak ataupun bad marketing. But it's okay, if you watch this video, maybe you can come here and experience the Indian food lah. Very nice. Rating kedai Bombay Spices. Persekitaran 4/5. Rasa macam grand restaurant. Makanan 5/5. Perfect taste. Fresh, panas-panas. Harga 3/5. Sedikit mahal bagi aku, tapi berbaloi lah. Maka keseluruhan ialah 4/5. Okay, sekarang kami di tempat yang keempat. Namanya Rainforest. Kedai terletak di area Batu 4. Kalau kau dari SK Hardway Batu 4, then you want to go to Pasar Dead Highway, then you can see this kedai di tepi jalan lah. Actually, this kedai recommend by my friend. Aku pun tahu ini wujud. Because memang nampak dari luar macam kedai bunga. So, jom lah kita try. Sekarang jam menunjukkan pukul 4 petang. Menurut Google Map, this is one of the peak hours for this kedai. For me, the environment is very okay lah, very nice. Okay. Because banyak bunga di belakang. Walaupun dari luar nampak macam kedai jual bunga. Right. So, makanan kami pada hari itu ialah mie apa, right? Mie mama. Then you see the telur is very nice. And then I also order ABC. This one Reflexia, and then this one is White Lady. Jom kita buat test.
Bolehlah.
Bolehlah. Sama ada kurang, macam. I don't know apa kurang. Ya, kalau dia kurang kecap. Sesuai minyak, maksudnya oren-oren. How is your white lady?
Emang
gak? Coba. Aku udah coba banyak white lady di Kuching, so let's try. Let's try this white lady. Ya, bisa okay. Good. Boleh. Try punya Reflexia tadi. First time lah, Reflexia. Saya pernah dengar nama Reflexia. Okay. Reflexia. It's just another ABC special there. Nothing special, but the food is not really up to my standard because ada something kurang. Aku datang dengan perut yang lapar makan this thing. To be honest, lama-lama makan tuh macam ada rasa mual-mual. Rating kedai Rainforest. Mesti kita run 2/5 walaupun suasana yang estetik tapi banyak lalat dan serangga-serangga lain. Makanan 3/5, banyak makanan yang habis and rasa yang ABC Saturday. Harga 2/5, a bit of a price to me. Maka keseluruhan ialah 2/5. Okay, so to ialah kedai kelima dalam video to. Siam sekarang menunjukkan pukul 4 dekat-dekat pukul 5. Berdasarkan Google Map, this is mereka punya peak hours lah. Tapi dari luar tengok macam I don't know what is going on. But then aku pun dah check Google Map tadi, and then the rating and then the review is like for this kedai, rating the lowest of this video lah. So don't waste any time. Jom kita pergi investigate. So basically dia kedai yang I think Indonesian style tambah mix with Western, I think. Dia kasih ada office kesihatan ke?
Sudah.
Yeah, kan? So by afternoon ataupun petang, usually what I assume they got it here. Tapi kan because I scout this place kan. Tidak pasti kan. So sudah orang.
This hour memang sudah makan tengah hari kan?
Yalah. Usually the peak hour is tengah hari and petang. Malam ada, tapi ya lah, that's why because the first time I saw this kedai kan, I go from there, and I go, apa kedai tak kosong? No. The second day aku pergi pun tak sama. So, maybe the test, aku takut juga actually pergi kedai itu, because orang kan masih sedang. Orang dekat review pun katanya lambat masak, so sekarang jam pukul 4:30, pukul berapa yang sampai? Oh, please
smells good,
ya. Yeah. Oke, makanan kami dah sampai. Kayak aku ada nasi goreng ayam. Apparently this is kedai, I think, pure Indonesian restaurant. The way mereka masak nasi goreng ayam pula. And then my cameraman order bakso. So this meatball, very big. Namanya bakso berada. Okay, so without wasting our energy and talking, makan dulu, test the food. It smells good. It smells good and look good. Bawang kok. Apa bawang?
Orang pergi pick hour nak kayak kami di luar. Quality itu.
That's the thing. Because aku dah tengok lah.
Masalah.
Pick hour mereka is around 12:05 ataupun dalam pukul 9 macam ni malam. So I go here pusing tengah. Siapa banyak orang?
During that hour lah.
Yes. So I think maybe it's the price point is the issue here lah. They cannot blame them also lah, because this one macam your Indonesian restaurant. Okay, ya. Cik liang. Okay, kami dah selesai makan. To be honest, my expectation datang to this kedai is very, 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 very low. But then they prove us wrong. The food is nice, nasi ayamnya very moist, very good. And then bakso-nya, meatball also very good. Kenyal ke apa? So would I come back? Yes, 100%. Cuma dia punya harga is a bit above average lah. I think that is why this kedai less customer. But then in terms of food, I have no comment. All very good. I think all very good, huh? Because this is, I think, 100% Indonesian Jawa restaurant. So you should come here and try this.
Rating kedai Ryan Cafe, persekitaran 4/5, nampak kemas dan banyak gambar makanan. Makanan 5/5, no comment, very good. Harga 3/5, agak mahal untuk makan biasa-biasa. Maka keseluruhan ialah 4/5. So that's it. I've tasted awful and incredible food in these 5 days. Apa yang aku boleh cakap ialah setiap kedai ada kekurangan dan kelebihan masing-masing. Tapi apa yang pasti ialah kekurangan mereka ialah marketing lah. Korang juga boleh pergi tempat yang aku pergi and comment kalau penilaian aku salah. And kalau kau tahu kedai yang selalu kosong, saya ada customer tapi takut nak cuba, you also can comment in the comment section. Maybe I will go there and try it myself. That's all from me today and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. Apa tak malah keep?